be sitting there on a power rack that you built 30 years ago.
Yeah, exactly.
I remember being in the back working on it, that kind of stuff.
You got all these ribbons from people that were actually here?
No, these are all from Carol.
Oh, from your wife.
Carol's got medals from all over the world. All those trophies are hers. All these medals are hers. Over here, there's more medals at the house. There's even more medals. She was in high school. She was in high school 2 years, and then junior college national champion 2 years, and then she went to UT, was all American 2 years, and now she's 57, still filling.
That is amazing. That is inspiring.
And a lot of cross-country ski medals. So that was her main sport before she started doing discus thrower. She's a real good cross-country skier.
The amount of equipment, the amount of history.
Interesting thing about the book from the 20s and 30s about Zhao and those guys, they want recipes. These days everybody wants to know what weight, what reps, how many sets.
They want to know exactly.
And they want to know a recipe for it. In their books, they just talked about this exercise, that exercise. Try it. Start off easy. When it gets easy, add some more weight to it. They didn't prescribe for it. These days, I mean, you flip through Muscle and Fitness, besides the fact that 2/3 of us
ads. Yep.
The rest of it is, you know, this exercise, this many reps, this many sets. And nobody wants to think of it.
Amazing. I am absolutely fascinated. It's a shame I discovered this when you're closing it.
Yeah, we didn't come out of the look acid. Using the line. Over at the museum, Dan Perry had one of Jowett's old anvils. I have over there a twin of his anvil made by the same Foster anvil coming out of England in 1844.
Really?
Same size, by the way.
Just amazing. All right, go to the sky. There's a $100 bill at the top. You are almost there. You are almost there.
When's the last time you had the thing checked up here?